I do believe we are live. Help, guys. Freezer Robot here. Today we are playing Rory Mcilroy PGA Tour. And we're doing pro career. What else? Freezer McRoebuck. I thought I started streaming earlier, but turns out I hadn't. So I am in the third hole. And now I'm minus one with birdie in a first hole, par in a second. We're on Sawgrass, and it's the first day. It's going pretty decent so far. So we are about, let's just jump back straight into it then. Third hole, Freezer McRoebuck's in fifth place at this tournament. I can't remember what it is. How far is it? It's saying about 100, 75. I wanna. There we go. Full swing.
And this is looking really good.
Ah,
good
should have put more spin
contact,
onto it.
Nice result, and a chance for birdie coming up.
Chance for birdie.
It's at sneaky distance.
I'll put it about here. Go on, go on, go on. Oh, what a shot.
And with that birdie,
well, though.
Third place.
Yeah, third.
Frank, how important is positioning off the tee here?
Well, we saw a positional tee shot at one and two. This is another one here at four.
Whack it.
Excellent looking shot here.
Yeah. That's how we
good
roll.
Tee shot, good lie, and now a good chance to take advantage here on this hole.
Web.com tour.
Frank, the second here at the fourth is a dangerous shot.
Once again, this is another example of where you have to look at the green. Where exactly is the flag? If it's on that high portion, you've got to fly it all the way back.
This is a good looking shot.
Ooh.
That is classy.
Shot. That is classy. Ooh.
Just needs to keep it steady here over the putt.
Yes. Another birdie.
Very impressive and on the move right now.
Climbing that table.
Now to the fifth. This long par four thought to be one of the most difficult holes on the front side here at the TPC Sawgrass.
If you've got plenty of length in the bag, you can almost take it directly over the bunker on the right. But if you're not as long, you have to air down that left side.
From the fairway.
Just a good solid tee shot right there, about 280 yards.
Damn right.
This, the second shot here at the par four.
I don't know if I made this. Oh, I am.
Appears to be a smart shot, Frank.
Yeah, no problem here. That's going to fly all the way. It was almost like that's what he wanted to do, but why would you want it to run over the back?
He'll need to be strong with this.
Go on, go on. Oh! Yeah.
Comfortably inside the cut line.
What a shot.
Frank, what do you think of the sixth? Pretty short par four.
It is, but you come out of that sort of corridor and fairway opens up and then it narrows up, bunkers to be around. Very, very few people hit driver here.
Very few. I'm going to be one of the few. Boosh. Great shot. Great shot. Yeah, my dude happy, y'all.
Frank, really good chance from this position to make a birdie.
Yeah, really the only thing he's looking at right now is the flag. This is a green light special.
Oh, wow, beautiful. Frank, dialed in. Beautiful.
Yeah, it was just some shot on that. Easy birdie.
That dude's very happy.
Just a couple of feet.
Easy birdie indeed.
That was a nice birdie, and no
doubt.
That was
a nice birdie.
Pretty good about his position on this leaderboard.
A series of good holes in a row has got him to this point.
Frank, seventh hole here at TPC Sawgrass. How do you break this one down?
Not overly long, 440 yards, but once again, it's a tee shot. If you're driving the ball well, that's fine. You just sort of blister it down there, but you're starting to lose one a little bit to the right. Ooh. There's three pot bunkers there, and of course, if you're fearful of it going left, there's the canal all the way down the left side that'll get your attention.
Ah, screw you, canal. Should really take a spin off.
Nothing to argue about there, right in the fairway.
After this hole, I'll take a spin off.
Now the approach to the seventh. Frank, what do you need to be mindful of here?
It's rather narrow in the front of this green, and then there's some mounds both right and left. Be very aware of those mounds. They can actually help you out.
Oh, what is it about? This'll do. Perfect shot.
Well, this one should be safely on deck here.
Ooh, nice.
Well, that is a ball striking putt right there. Another dazzling approach shot. Pretty close. These putts keep the round together.
Yeah, another birdie.
Racking them and stacking them right now. Six under par for the tournament.
After seven, on my seven.
Here we are at the eighth at Pete Dye's famed stadium course at the TPC Sawgrass. Rich Lerner alongside Frank Navolo. Frank, this is a hole that I really like.
And players do too, Rich, especially off that back tee where it must be about 80 yards of chute that you go through before the hole actually starts to open up. And this green, 11 bunkers in total around the whole putting surface.
All right. So I need to put swing difficulty on normal. That's power boost off. Spinner keep off. Green grid on. Yeah. Shot shaping off. Light effect normal. I'm not really good with shot shifting. Shot shaping. Wind gust off or wind gust on? Zoom off and aiming arc off. Right, so wind gust. Yeah, I can do this. Random wingos is so good. And it should be pretty much identical to what we're using apart from spin control. Right, now let's get back into it. Par 3. Hit that. I got no spin.
Didn't check, Frank.
Yeah, just not enough spin on that. Really, I mean, that almost like took that first bounce and just ricocheted forward.
Oh well. Can't play without me spin.
Ball sitting down here in the rough. He's digging in.
Oh, it don't matter because it saves it.
That just is amazing. What a birdie. Just a mind blower right there. Absolutely incredible. He made the shot. Frank, I think this is one of the most fascinating holes on the golf course. The 583-yard par 5 ninth hole.
With technology now, a lot more players can reach this par 5 and 2. Gone are the days where it was a true three-shotter, but I remember when Sergio Garcia hit that 3-wood from, what was it, 270, 280 yards? Still one of the best shots I've ever seen.
Frank, one of our colleagues at Golf Channel, Brian Hammonds, always liked to say, keep it in the short grass. It is nice to play from the fairway.
The game's so much easier from the fairway. Less decisions to be made. You don't have to worry about a flyer or the lip in front of the bunker or a tree. The game almost appears straightforward from there.
I want to go for it. Put driver. Oh no, get out there. Yeah.
Now the third shot here at the ninth, Frank.
Another very narrow green, not that dissimilar to the first hole. There's a high portion on the left and a low portion on the right.
Seems to like it. Headed for the fat part of the green.
Ooh.
Can't hide the flag stick from that man.
Beautiful. Could have been for his proper inside
over the putt.
Pretty simple at the minute. That might just be against people I'm up against, though.
Just continuing to play some really good golf. 8 under par for the championship.
Having a great start to the season. I have to check what difficulty
just a superb performance on the front side. He's hoping to keep it going here on the back nine, Frank.
The game is so much easier when you're swinging well, putts are going in. Really, you've just got to keep out of your own way.
Frank, we're really watching the next generation of PGA Tour stars, aren't we?
Yeah, this
sure
player
are.
In particular, Rich, amateur pedigree, already a winner of the NCAAs, and I've always thought that success early on is a predictor, really, of talent long-term, and this player has all the tools.
I have all the tools.
There's something about a well-hit shot.
Get it on. Get on that where.
Looks to be a good setup going into the green here at the 10th.
What a shot.
Second shot now at the 10th, and again, Frank, accuracy is at a premium.
Yeah, gone are the days to sort of thrash it out of the trees like Phil Mickelson. Ideally, coming out of that fairway, you're hitting to a green that moves to the right, so that makes it a little bit more difficult than what the mind's eye first sees.
Hey.
On the green, and a chance for birdie.
Picking it up now. Woo! Hello,
birdie. An amazing display. The records continue to fall.
8 more holes to go.
Hole number 11, 558 yard, par 5. Frank, players in attack mode here.
Yeah, just try and blitz it down there. There are other bunkers on the left to consider, but really, with that much fairway, this is a green light opportunity.
Should be able to get it from green from here.
That one is in the fairway, down there about 290 yards.
Good, good.
Second from an excellent lie.
Come on. Yeah. Crowd loving it.
All right, Frank, the 11th is a reachable. What's the right strategy?
Well, it feels like that green should be about another 30 or 40 yards to the right, Rich. Makes the player aim left, and it's such a narrow green, but it's worth the risk.
Well, Frank, obviously, way too much club there.
You've got to think something like that, or at least misread the wind. This is never going to sit down.
What?
Not a gimme, but well within his range.
Come on. Yeah, another birdie. So
really starting to shine, moves to 10 under for the tournament. Here now the 12th hole at the TPC Sawgrass. It's a 358-yard par 4, so short on the card, Frank, but obviously a challenge. What's the key here?
Once again, trying to find that right position on the fairway, and that's down the right side. Anything down the left, that mound is going to block your view.
Frank, that ball sitting up like it's on plush carpeting.
Rich, if you and I had lies like that every time, we'd still be playing this game for a living.
That should be pretty good right there. On the safe
yeah.
side. That will be a great look at birdie.
Going for another birdie.
Been pretty good all day from this distance. Just trying to take care of business.
Oh, yeah.
Well, in the words of the late Sweet. Great baseball commentator for the Yankees, Phil Rizzuto, it's time for Holy Cow, Whitey. That's 11 under par.
That right. Well, I like it. Look at this one.
Excellent play right there. The approach, giving him another good look.
I'm right.
This is an 11-foot putt.
Yeah.
That had to really hurt, Frank, because it looked good all the way.
Well, this will test his middle.
Could use this, a putt for par.
Whee.
So has the par. Moving on to the next hole in the lead, Frank is very much intact.
Damn right. That's six.
14th hole, 481 yard, par 4, ranking second in difficulty, Frank.
Yeah, this one always gets overlooked, Rich. You've only got to flick the drive a little left, and all of a sudden your round just gets completely wrecked. Ask Vijay Singh. Cost him a player's championship. Many a player there has dealt with that left side guy. It, you will pay the price.
Good tee shot, right in the short grass.
What?
Frank, as players get set to make that next step, to graduate to the PGA Tour, what part of their game has to really be sharp?
Well, nowadays, all the players are powerful, so you're looking for other things rather than straight power. One of those things is adaptability. When you get out there on that first year on the PGA Tour, remember, you're going to be playing these venues for the very first time. Against people that have played it 10, 15 times, perhaps, so they have an advantage. So you're going to have to adapt very, very quickly and put the time in.
Nice. What a... Oh.
Midway through this back nine, could use this birdie here at the 14th.
We got this.
Young
we got this.
Star.
We got this.
Birdie putt coming up.
I don't think we got this.
Chance to gain a stroke over the field and graduate to the PGA Tour.
Come on. Ah, that's terrible. Terrible.
You couldn't ask for much more than that, except to make it. Settles in over the putt.
Ooh.
Nothing wrong with
Pause
that.
Pause it with thick and fast.
Back to the TPC Sawgrass, the 15th hole. It's a par 4 as we make our way to this finishing stretch. And Frank, what's in store for the players here?
Whoa.
Another one of those par 4s around 450 yards. Ideally hit a tee shot down the right side, keeping it away from that bunker. But that's a flat bunker down the right with no lip, so it's still not too bad. Biggest problem here is that green. So many undulations on this green.
This green.
Frank, this is a position where a player is absolutely licking his chops here. Good chance to make a birdie.
Yeah, this is when this game just looks like fun. Bunkers don't seem to be in play. The only thing you're really looking at right now is just the flag. Surely not.
Oh, he's a bit more spit.
That's how you play the game, right there. Stick it in close and then knock in the birdie. Shouldn't be a problem here, but not a formality either.
Oh.
Man.
I just pushed it.
Boy, that hurts.
Oh, yeah,
he
does.
Has this for par.
Got a par.
You like the sound of this. 11 under par for the round. Frank, I think one of the things that fans love about this gauntlet, 16, 17, and 18, each hole has that sort of hold-your-breath moment. Certainly 17, we know when that ball's in the air, you're holding your breath. Is it wet or dry? 16, same on that second shot. You're holding your breath wondering, where is it? Right in the water or left with a chance for three?
That's why you don't want to get too sloppy on that tee shot. A lot of people look at 16 because there's a wide fairway and they think
not
just
shot.
Get it down there.
Not shot.
The extra 10 or 15 yards, there's a little ridge down that left side. If you catch that, the ball will kick good 20 yards further forward. 20 yards is two clubs. I'd much rather go into 17 with a 4-iron than a 2-iron.
I'm gonna go this way. Bro, get on that green. Get on that green. Oh, beautiful.
Not quite where he was aiming. That one far to the left, but still on the green. Frank, I'm not saying he should pull out driver here, but this is a long putt.
Greens are fast, though. You never know. Good line, good pace. Might have a chance.
That was not a very good read right there.
You're not a very good read. It was so close. Has that not been it?
Looking putt, just not falling right now.
No, sadly, he's going to be disappointed.
And getting ready for the putt.
Oh!
And let's hope he doesn't make double bogey now.
That's the saddest coming out in your reach.
Just a tap in to finish the hole.
Shouldn't have been a bogey at all.
Still has the lead.
I can't believe that. That's just
Frank, how early in the
unfair.
Round are you thinking about the shot at 17?
Well, when you're playing well, you're pushing it ahead. Maybe you don't think about it till 14 or 15. If you're struggling, you might be thinking it early as the fifth or the sixth hole. But put it this way, when you make the walk from 16 to 17, you are thinking of it every inch of the way.
What a shot.
The game, right there.
Spin.
Just a couple of feet.
Yeah. Made up for that bogey.
Pretty much doing everything right this week. 11 under for the tournament.
Have another go.
TPC Sawgrass, 462-yard par 4. Frank, is this one of the toughest finishing holes in the sport?
It is, because the simple reason you played 17 holes and the job isn't done yet.
Yeah, that's a good shot.
Always makes the hole easier, playing it from the fairway.
Very good shot as well.
Now the approach shot here at 18, just one last good swing, Frank.
There's a little false front here that you have to avoid, so something that pitches over that right bunker that lands a good 10 or so yards on this green is certainly the desired goal.
Seems to like it. Headed for the fat part of the green.
No, I don't think I'm going to get
well
birdie.
Now a good look at birdie.
Come on.
This is an awkward length.
Oh.
He was fooled a little bit on that one, Frank. Trying to get out of here without too many bumps and bruises. This one is for bogey.
just an amazing display. The records continue to fall.
Hey, it's
Frankie, surprised to see that name on top of the leaderboard.
I am surprised to see the name, but not that style of golf leading. It was great performance, especially tee to green. You don't often see people start that quickly.
Level four. Nice. And that's just after 18 holes. Read a book. Not bad at all. No attribute bonuses.
Yeah.
All my attributes are going up though. Hey, 62 overall. Nice. Still in the lead. Setting up tournament structures. Creating leaderboard. We'll do one more day. I might finish it, to be honest. Just do it all.
EA Sports and the Web.com Tour proudly present second round coverage of the Web.com Tour Championship. Moving into the second round of the Web.com Tour Championship, the fourth and final stop of the Web.com Tour Finals. And Frank, you can feel the pressure building.
You certainly feel it building. I expect that we're going to see more of what we saw yesterday, which is some fearless golf. And these guys are playing for a PGA Tour card, and they're not backing down.
Damn right. The leaderboard.
And let's go down to the first. On the first tee, our featured golfer, Frank, has to be brimming with confidence.
They have to feed off the round from the previous day, Rich. It was a very, very good performance. And we're going to soon find out, see what these opening swings are like.
Yeah, just give us a minute and I'll show you what these opening swings are like. Oh, can hit it 260 yards now. Cheers. Like my second day best top. I have to change your clothes like for every day.
Right where they were aiming in the fairway. Frank, you want to get off to a good start. This approach shot here at the first is important.
It is. Two distinct levels on this this green. The high side on the left there and the lower side on the right. If you're trying to keep that ball a little left of a middle, you got to be careful of that bunker on the left.
Just going to have to give me a second, guys. I'm just doing something on my phone. I have to sort something out. But don't worry. It's time. Right then, let's get on that green. What is it, about 169 yards. I do 160. I'm gonna put it full. Are we gonna move it?
That should be pretty good right there. On the safe side. Put a birdie on the card here yesterday. Don't forget.
Yeah, I did.
Trying to make yet another birdie.
So look at this green then. Ah, it's pretty much straight. Yeah, another birdie.
Great start.
Frank, what do you make of the par 5 second?
Doglegs to the left, so there's a decision to be made here all the time, but a good hooking tee shot, that takes the trees on the left out of play, and even the rough on the right. Good tee shot here. I've seen people get home with as little as a 5-iron.
Really? As little as a fairbone? Right then. I'm all ready. Could bang this. I want to go there. Back here. Go on, Sonny Jim. Woo woo. They like me. Yeah.
Looks like he's going to have a go at it here. Part five, the second shot.
If I hit it right, I can get it over. Yeah.
That
good
was
for
a
an
big,
eagle.
Bold strike, and now a chance for a big, bold move. Putt for eagle coming up. Getting set now over the putt.
Oh, that's
just
terrible.
Misses. It happens sometimes, Frank. They don't all drop.
No, but you try telling them right now.
Got a birdie. Should have got the eagle after.
Another birdie.
What the birdie will have to do.
Two birdies.
Duck. Quack. Quack, quack.
So we started with a par four, then a par five, and now the 177-yard par three third hole. Plenty of hazards here, Frank.
Yeah, you really break this green up into three portions. Front left, front right, and that back, just on top of the ridge. Well, this is straight at it.
That's a really good line.
Wait.
Excellent shot to within 10 feet. Not a gimme, but well within his range.
Oh, I'm just trying to get used to this putting on
here. Missed the bunny. That's like missing a layup in basketball. Did the job right there. Frank, the bunker on the right, I wouldn't call that a pot bunker. That is some kind of a hazard, isn't it?
Yeah, meanders all the way down the right side, but really it's the lesser of two evils. I'd rather be in that bunker on the right than the hill on the left.
I'm just going to whack it from here and hopefully I don't get a bunker. Sorted. Nice shot, McRoebuck. Brilliant shot.
He has given this one the full treatment. Perfect release through the ball. This shot is on the fairway, over 300 yards. Frank, the second here at the fourth is a dangerous shot.
Once again, this is another example of where you have to look at the green. Where exactly is the flag? If it's on that high portion, you've got to fly it all the way back.
Go on.
This is a good-looking shot.
Oh,
that is
beautiful.
Exceptional shot on the green and in position for a birdie.
Yeah, it's
another birdie.
This hole's been good to him. Birdie yesterday.
Birdie today. Puka.
Once considered the best player at the college level, our featured golfer makes birdie sitting comfortably inside the cut line.
I'm guessing they get the birdie seen.
I lost count the number of bunkers here, off the tee and sort of in play with the second shot if you're in trouble, or even the one that's sort of left and long. Really good par four, though. Fairway somehow has to be achieved if you want to reduce this par four to just a simple two-shotter.
Oh, yeah. Got all that spin. I have spin. Oh,
that's a good start to the hole, right down the middle. This is the second shot at the par four.
Can't zoom in. I got no aim in art. At least let me have some spin. Go on.
Appears to be a smart shot, Frank.
Yeah, no problem here. That's going to fly all the way.
Should have put my backspin on it.
Game right there. Knock it on the green and give yourself a good look at birdie.
It's at sneaky distance.
Come on. Oh.
Good try. Just didn't quite read the break, Frank.
It shouldn't be a problem, you'd think, cleaning up here for Pop.
Locked in on the read and the speed.
Yeah. Got a par. Well done, lad.
In for par.
Oh, that's actually right quick. I'm running away with this. I'm getting
Frank,
that PGA
you don't
tour card.
Cute with that second shot here at the sixth.
I remember many a time, Rich, when they put the flag right of center. You try and hit a little bit too close, those palm trees all of a sudden come into play. Hits one of those, that ball can go anywhere.
Excellent looking shot
nice
here.
Nice hit. Yeah.
Frank, that golf ball sitting up like a red velvet cake in a bakery. It looks pretty, doesn't it?
Time to take a bite of it. Savor it. Hit the next one close.
Frank, this is a position where a player is absolutely licking his chops here. Good chance to make a birdie.
Yeah, this is when this game just looks like fun. Bunkers don't seem to be in play. The only thing you're really looking at right now is just the flag.
Yeah.
Can't hide the flag stick from that man.
Okay.
He has this putt for birdie.
Easy putt. Damn right.
And he has it.
A good putt redeems all.
Burning for
Frank,
a minute.
What do you think of the seventh?
Interesting par four. For two reasons. The undulating green on the end of the hole that also shapes to the right that makes it look like a dogleg right. But really, you want to play that tee shot just inside those pot bunkers down the right side.
Try and get it right here. That's the plan. See if it pays off. Oh, it's going to pay off. Yeah, good shot. Well done, McRoebuck.
Now the approach to the seventh. Frank, what do you need to be mindful of here?
It's rather narrow in the front of the screen, and then there's some mounds both right and left. Be very aware of those mounds. They can actually help you out.
I think you said that
this
last time.
This one should be safely on deck here.
Yeah.
We just saw a player in total control of what he's doing. Didn't miss a green in regulation all day long. He really likes this hole. Made birdie yesterday. Can he do it again today?
Of course he can. I like how they play back to the last holes, like from the day before. That's good. You want to do quick rounds, but I decided to do full rounds because what's the point? Just doing quick rounds. If I'm doing a tour, I'm doing a tour.
Frank, this is a hole that I really like.
And players do too, Rich, especially off that back tee where it must be about 80 yards of shoot that you go through before the hole actually starts to open up. And this green, 11 bunkers in total around the whole putting surface.
That's well played.
I just didn't know. I didn't really think.
Good look at birdie.
Good look at birdie, yeah. How far? 20 foot? About 18. What's about here? Oh, look at look at him! Look at him! He's so happy! Yeah! Definitely my dude if he's acting like that.
Frank, I think this is one of the most fascinating holes on the golf course. The 583-yard par 5 ninth hole.
With technology now, a lot more players can reach this par 5 and 2. Right, gone are the days where it was a true three-shotter, but I remember when Sergio Garcia hit that three-wood from, what was it, 270, 280 yards? Still one of the best shots I've ever seen.
I could potentially get on the green from here.
Second shot.
Not yet. Can't get it on the green just yet.
Now the third shot here at the ninth, Frank.
Another very narrow green, not that dissimilar to the first hole. There's a high portion on the left and a low portion on the right.
That's it. Fits it right, yeah. Yeah.
Terrific golf shot. And now that for an easy birdie. Looking to make a move. This putt for birdie.
Another birdie.
Just an amazing display. The records continue to fall.
Smashing it.
Just a superb performance on the front side. He's hoping to keep it going here on the back nine, Frank.
The game is so much easier when you're swinging well, putts are going in. Really, you've just got to keep out of your own way.
Nice drive.
Looks to be a good setup going into the green here at the 10th. Frank, where's the difficulty on this approach here at the 10th?
It's really the shape of this green. That little front piece, you have to be right on the money there. And then, of course, that green starts to open up and then move to the right.
This one is definitely heading left. Looks like it is going to end up in the rough.
Nope. On the green.
Pretty good result right there. Considering
it looked rough all the way.
Exactly.
Rich, really did.
This for another birdie on this hole on the week.
Oh, yeah. My dude don't mess about.
Can't wait to write those on the card. One below par. Chalk it up. It's a birdie.
One below par. I don't think
so. Let's go to the 11th now. It's a par 5 and a fun hole, Frank. You can make anything from 3 to 7 here.
And that's why, as the start of the back nine, especially on a Sunday, this becomes such a pivotal hole to start a run. Big body of sand down the left side that sometimes the longer hitters can get close to with the tee shot. But really, it's the second shot. If you can reach this par 5, it's a very narrow green. The layup, well, it's actually an awkward layup, Rich, because you've got to push that ball to the left side, almost like a zigzag approach.
Nice position, short grass, second shot.
With it, driver. Get in bunker, but I'm with it, green. You all live once. I'm not saying, what is it? Who dares? As Smythe would say, I'm going
that
in that bunker.
Bunker bound, it looks like. Oh, a bit unfortunate. Wasn't able to avoid the sand trap. Great professionals, Frank. They don't fear the greenside bunker shot, do they?
No, because you can be as aggressive or as conservative as you want. You actually have far more options. And you don't have to hit the ball first.
Oh, yes.
It's like cyber vision. Shot after shot, right at the flag.
Just dialed in. 10-foot putt left.
10-foot putt left. Go on. Yeah, another birdie. That's how I do it.
We have said it over and over. Another birdie. Up to the 12th, Frank, a good birdie chance here.
Yeah, good old link.
I'm guessing it's
got to
be the
difficult
one.
The screen really divides itself into about three sections. There's a little piece to the right, piece short left, and the one at back left. So as long as you know where the flag is, just push that ball into the section where it is. You get up there, you're only going to have 10 or 15 feet left for birdie.
Nice.
Paying attention like a little kid at school, Frank. That baby's sitting up.
Sitting up? It's got the best view as well. You don't even need binoculars from where that ball is.
This drive down the left side, Frank.
Yeah, it creates a blind second shot because of the mounds in front. So a little bit of guesstimation coming up here, but still only a short iron.
What is it about? Put it about 85.
That should be pretty good right there. On the safe side.
Ooh!
What a display of shot making this has been, Frank.
Oh, that incredible approach shot there. The easiest of birdies coming up.
Call me the birdie, man. Oh, yeah. He's made it for a birdie. Hashtag birdie, man. Minus 20.
One of the great things about this golf course, Frank, a variety of par threes, different yardages. Here at the 13th, 181-yard par three.
Yeah, this is where you have to be careful on the tee there. Anything left's just going to be eaten up by that lake. Matter of fact, if you hit one with a little bit of a hook and it catches the mound, it can still kick into the lake. So this one here, just be a little cautious on the tee.
I'm the roughie,
yeah.
It was
almost like that's what he wanted to do, but why would you want it to run over the back?
Second shot coming out of the rough here.
Oh, but it doesn't matter because he's chipping it in. Oh, another birdie from the freeze.
Frank, 14.
Hashtag birdie, man.
Pivotal hole here at the TPC Sawgrass.
It is, Rich. And when you see a player hit two shots comfortably on this green, you think, what's all the problems about 14? But when you see someone stray left or stray right, you realize that 14 is a real bear.
Real, yeah. We all know, man. Real.
A great way to start a hole, nicely placed in the fairway.
Look how happy he is. We all just teed off, like, chill out.
Shot here at the 14th.
Yeah, there's some subtle mounds in this green. One that comes in on the right, and then another one that starts to come in about two-thirds of the way down on that left side.
Aldo.
He's making the game look very simple right now. See it, hit it, and he's got it right on track. Been pretty good all day from this distance, just trying to take care of business.
Push. Another birdie.
Seems to have a touch today.
How are all?
Frank, the 15th hole certainly has the respect of the professionals.
But you're right, this is a positional hole where just keep the ball down the left center. You can't go too far, though, because you'll get blocked out or you'll run out of fairway. From there, it's really about knowing where the flag is, what position on the screen, because this is another green that's not flat. If the second shot lands on the wrong portion of the green, we'll finish.
No bunkering where the hole. Well, it is, but not as close. Take the crowd in, like,
once again,
embrace it.
Is so important as we look at the second shot to the 15th.
Yeah, you're looking at the flag here. You're looking at birdie, but if you miss, the big bunker on the left will swallow it up, and there's two little pop bunkers on the right. Tough to get it up and down.
Seems to like it. Headed for the fat part of the green.
Ooh.
That's good stuff right there. Wonderful approach.
Close approach.
Now, a really good look at birdie. Made par yesterday. This one for birdie.
Yeah.
And he has it for birdie.
Running away with this. You know this, man.
You licking your chops here, Frank, as a player, when you get to this tee box?
Well, it's an opportunity. A four here certainly makes the mood better when you walk to 17 and then 18. So a four here is more than just making a birdie on a par five.
We'll try and get it past them trees. Oh, nice. Now the lake's not a problem.
Rich, not only is that a good drive, that is a perfect
Take it in, lad.
That's the kind of lie.
Maybe a while before you hear it again.
Frank, what we've learned over the years is that the Web.com Tour is such a good place to hone your skills for the next step for the PGA Tour because it replicates the PGA Tour environment. 72 holes, a lot of pressure, you're playing for money, and you need to shoot 65s and 66s to win.
It's harder in golf to make that direct comparison, and I think to add to your point, if you used other sports, for example, like baseball, AAA, as opposed to regular season baseball, the guy has a specialist position. He's a pitcher or catcher. You can directly correlate his ability with another one in the major leagues. The same with NFL.
Yes.
Color, size, speed, and the combine, as opposed to professional.
Eagle!
NFL. It's so multifaceted. So therefore, if you have a good combination of game, it might not stand out initially, but it might be better in the long haul.
This one checking in at 150 yards.
Frankie's cranking it and banking it. Giant drives, a boatload of birdies. What a round.
Yeah, these are the days you just dream for. We know golf's not that easy, but on a day like today, savor it and just keep going. Keep doing it.
Yeah.
Wow, Frank, he is dialed in.
Yeah, that was just some shot.
Unstoppable.
Easy, buddy.
Bogey here yesterday. Chance to better that today.
Did I? Not today. Birdie.
And he has it.
A good putt.
Sawgrass is good. So I love Sawgrass. Really good. Really good golf course.
Now one of the more difficult holes in golf. The 18th here at Sawgrass. 462-yard par 4. In 2013, this hole averaged 0.39 strokes above par. What makes it so challenging, Frank?
Just that big body of water that to the left of 18 here, that's also shared to the right of 9. Not a single fairway bunker on this 18th hole. So really, lack of definition. It's so hard to find a target here.
Now his final approach shot of the day, just wants to go out in style.
One more good swing.
Appears to be a smart shot, Frank.
Yeah, no problem here. That's going to fly all the way.
Ooh. Mount Green.
Frank, it hit the green, but just didn't have enough backspin.
You wonder what he was thinking on that.
Oh.
Solid.
I'd say cannot win.
Really not much to this. The only issue would be a lack of concentration or focus.
Finish up with par day two. Nicely done.
Right there. We'll settle for par.
I will settle for par. You know this, man.
Well, Rich, two rounds in the books, and it's easy to see why the leaders are on top of that leaderboard.
Excellent performance, but still a long ways to go in this tournament.
That's it. You ranked that up. You're 100, level 7. What am I on about? I'll read it to next level. Nicely done. Attribute bonus. Nice. Getting my stats up. Simulating the other golfers based on their attributes. Not bad after the second round. I'm still top by about 20. 20 under par in front. Wrecking them bunkers. Web.com tour. Not so tough. So go on this. I'm up with my power. Have a look at the new stuff. Wait, these are all new. I've already got these. What are you running about the new? Ooh, long sleeves. I can't have them. Can I have a green sweater? Yeah, why would I want to view a lot? Alright, that could be my next one. Yeah, let's put him in some shorts. Hats. We got any cool hats? That green one. Ah. And Saturday is just pretty much my Thursday stuff. I mean Sunday. We'll change the Sunday one. I mean, the Thursday one. Keep getting my days messed up. I've got the vest top, got a long sleeve. Wear a green t-shirt. Yeah. Got a blue one. Got a blue glove. I'm happy with that. So I locked some orange things. Got my equipment. Change drivers. I'll take that new driver. And 9.5 my driver, isn't it? Is it? Yeah, 9.5. Ugh, I got it a lot. Might go for the yellow ball. Continue with this event since I can't got really anything else to lock and change. Web.com tours. Oh, that's what I want to look at. Is there anywhere to look at difficulties? Apparently not. I'm guessing it's all one difficulty. Just gonna have to roll with it. Do this.
EA Sports and the Web.com Tour proudly present third round coverage of the Web.com Tour Championship. We are into the third round of the Web.com Tour Championship, the fourth and final stop of the Web.com Tour Finals. 50 PGA Tour cards up for grabs, dreams about to be made.
It's amazing right. What's ahead of these young players, Rich. Not just getting through the next two rounds, but also trying to suppress perhaps what might be for them next year.
Look at my dude. Yeah, I don't need to look at that. 6 mile an hour winds. Winds are getting crazy now. Minus 20.
Pretty good drive here.
Yeah, my lead's gonna get reduced, I think.
Good tee shot, we'll right see. In the short grass.
Yo,
Frank, you want to get out of the gates quickly. Hit the proper approach shot here at the first. What does the player need to look out for?
Well, there's two distinct levels to the screen. There's that left side, and then that collection area to the right side. Flag on the top. It's a very, very difficult shot because that bunker plump comes into play.
Roll, stop.
That just came out blazing. As soon as it hit the green, it was never going to stop.
Quite not being good on these so far. Can I do it again? Oh!
Okay, good shot on the dance floor.
On the dance floor.
Clean this up with a tap.
Nicely done.
Did the job right there. How about this second, a par five?
Well, if you're brave, you try and flash it down that tree line down the left, but there's a couple of limbs that poke out. Every now and again, they catch an errant tee shot.
Not catching this one.
Well, this one's sweet, Frank.
Super. Very sweet. This one's sweet, Frank. Super.
That's a good shot, right where you want to be, in the fairway here at number two. And now the second shot here at this par five.
Stop it.
Frank, this one's not looking good.
Yeah, certainly not down the fairway line, heading toward the rough.
I'm on the fairway. What's your point? What's your problem,
good result,
mate?
Right there, considering
it looked rough all the way.
Exactly.
Rich, really did.
Third shot coming up at this par five. Still a good chance to make birdie.
Yeah, just make sure you have the right number and the right club.
Nice.
Good chance now for a birdie. That was an outstanding play.
Well, it's almost a guarantee there after that shot.
And this will be a 5-foot putt here.
Oh, I thought I missed. Birdie.
Rich, that just adds insult to injury to the rest of the field. Another birdie and the gap even wider.
And sensational Miles performance. Wide. Frank, a nice mix of holes to start. So here we go with a par three at the third.
Very narrow at the front of this green, and that bunker too, you don't actually see it off the tee, the back left bunker, and it sneaks into that left side. So if that flag is on the left, just be careful. Yeah, this is straight at it.
It's a really good line.
Nice.
This hole really sets up well for the player. Birdie yesterday, and a chance for another one today. Birdie here yesterday, trying to do it again today.
Oh yeah. Running away with this.
Get in. Yes, good putt.
Running away with it.
So much focus here, Frank, on 16, 17, and 18. Number four is a hole that gets overlooked, but it's a fun one.
Yeah, the second shot here is more daunting, especially when that flag's on the left. So you really do start looking at that blue stuff, water.
Good job it's on the right then, isn't it?
That one is in the fairway, down there about 290 yards. Frank, the second here at the fourth is a dangerous shot.
Once again, this is another example of where you have to look at the green. Where exactly is the flag? If it's on that high portion, you've got to fly it all the way back.
Seems to like it. Looks like it's headed for the green.
Ah.
You can't hide the flag stick from that man.
He is just unbelievable. That never deviated offline.
Oh yeah. Running away with a web.com.
So Frank, what do you think of the start so far?
Running away with it like no.
Frank, the golf course toughens up right here at the long par 4 fifth.
Yeah, when you play it off the back tee, 470 yards, it's nearly 320 yards to that last bunker down the left side. That really has to be in the back of your mind. The ideal tee shot, little left to right.
Nice little. You can hear me. They're cheering for me. Yeah, I hear
Frank,
you. Bro.
Really good chance from this position to make a birdie.
Yeah, really the only thing he's looking at right now is the flag. This is a green light special.
Could put a bit of backspin on that.
That will be a great look at birdie. Locked in on the read and the speed.
Oh.
Came to the putt excited to make birdie. Now, settle for par.
Yeah, little change in the attitude right now. When you've let one go, you've got to really knuckle down there. Make sure you don't drop a shot. It's important this one goes.
Why?
Well, that's disappointing. He misses the par putt, and he'll have this for bogey. So just a formality here.
In this situation, Richard, bogey's not all that bad. Still has the lead.
just by miles, I still have that lead.
Frank, what do you think of the sixth?
I'm disappointed in the ballgame.
It is, but you come out of that sort of corridor and fairway opens up and then it narrows up, bunkers to be around. Very, very few people hit driver here. There's something about a well-hit shot.
Oh, yeah. That wind's a bit of a B. The BB.
Frank, now the second shot here at hole number six.
Yeah, not overly long, but be very aware of these palm trees that are short. Many a shot caught those trees coming into this green.
Yeah.
That is an excellent play. The approach shot within 12 feet. Now this for birdie came away with par in the previous round.
Oh.
Frankie took plenty of time on this birdie putt. He looked at it from three different angles. He forgot one very important ingredient.
Yeah, pace. You can definitely fall in love with the line, even with approach shots as well, but obviously we see it more on putting.
Workmanlike hole.
Par.
He walks away with a par. Frank, the seventh hole here at the TPC Sawgrass, vintage Pete Dye, isn't it?
It is. Anything other than straight. Confuses the player off the tee. But there's three pot bunkers down the right side, just inside that last little
carry me wind
on the left of that. Actually a pretty good line.
This one is definitely heading left. Looks like it is going to end up in the rough.
Oh.
We moved that one out there, but he is not going to like the lie.
That moved down in the rough.
Second shot coming out of the rough here. Appears to be a smart shot, Frank.
Yeah, no problem here. That's going to fly all the way.
Stop. On the green.
Really in control of this hole. Birdie yesterday. Grr. Another opportunity on the way. Standing over this putt, concentrating on the read. Well, that is a good looking putt, just not falling right now.
Sadly, he's going to be disappointed.
I'll deal with a par. Okay, it's tough now, these are all these greens.
Frank, a par here. That's just fine.
I got plenty.
Plenty here we are at the 8th, Pete Dye's famed stadium course at the TPC Sawgrass. Rich Lerner alongside Frank Navolo. Frank, this is a hole that I really like.
And players do too, Rich, especially off that back tee where it must be about 80 yards of chute that you go through before the hole actually starts to open up. And this green, 11 bunkers in total around the whole putting surface.
Well, that's how you play the game right there. Knock it on the green and give yourself a good look.
How's that a close approach?
This is an awkward length.
Nope. Ah, another par.
You hate to miss from that distance.
He's not happy. Oh, he should be happy with that.
You have to make that, don't you?
Drop shot. What's wrong with you? Don't blame the brigid putter. Best of days at the office today, hasn't it?
Bad news is, Frank, that's a bogey, but the good news...
Saturday seems to be the beginning. Throwing in outside.
Frank, I think this is one of the most fascinating holes on the golf course. The 583-yard par 5 ninth hole.
With technology now, a lot more players can reach this par 5 and 2. Gone are the days where it was a true three-shotter, but I remember when Sergio Garcia hit that 3-wood from, what was it, 270, 280 yards? Still one of the best shots I've ever seen.
Oh, yes.
Second shot.
I often drive, wind's going to move me.
Frank, this one's going too far left, it looks like.
Yeah, it was fine there for a little while, but if it keeps going left, it's doomed.
Frank, better than we thought it was going to be.
Yeah, that looked like it was headed for that thick stuff the whole way, but a little fortunate. But then I guess you're allowed that in this game.
Well, this one should be safely on deck here.
Nice.
Wow, Frank, he is dialed in.
Yeah, that was just some shot on there. Easy birdie.
This hole's been good to him. Birdie yesterday. I'm trying for another one today.
And that's my third birdie. Third birdie on that hole.
Yeah, he's made it for a birdie.
Freezer McRoebuck.
Well, that was a nearly flawless performance on the front side, but Frank, we know it's an 18-hole game, isn't it?
That's right. Now's not the time to pat yourself on the back.
I got this.
That's a good spot right there.
Center
good, good strike.
Looks to be a good setup going into the green here at the 10th. Second shot now at the 10th, and again, Frank, accuracy is at a premium.
Yeah, gone are the days to sort of thrash it out of the trees like Phil Mickelson. Ideally, coming out of that fairway, you're hitting to a green that moves to the right. So that makes it a little bit more difficult than what the mind's eye first sees.
Superb shot.
Well, that's as good as it's going to get. There's going to be no worries about making that one.
You don't want to let this one get away. This is about concentration and focus at this point.
And he does it.
He's made it.
Par five.
Now on to one of the most exciting back nines in golf here at the TPC Sawgrass and the stadium course. Let's begin at number 10, Frank, and what do you make of this hole?
It's another one where you're just trying to fit the tee shot in the fairway there. It's not a driver, just something that stays right. And of course, we've seen a lot of people stray here down the left side. Who can forget Mickelson when he won his Players' Championship, hitting that phenomenal 7-iron out of the fairway bunker, through the trees, and still finding the putting surface. But speaking of the putting surface, this green has more undulations than just about any green on the golf course.
Second from an excellent lie.
Stay on that fairway. That's it.
All right, Frank, the 11th is a reachable. What's the right strategy?
Well, it feels like that green should be about another 30 or 40 yards to the right, Rich. Makes the player aim left, and it's such a narrow green, but it's worth the risk.
Early part of this second nine, and a good approach shot, and now pretty good chance for birdie.
Go on. Oh, beautiful.
And rolls it in. Nice putt. Up now, hole number 12. It's a short one, 358 yard, par 4.
This can catch you off guard. If you just try and hit the ball on the fairway, if you are on the middle of the fairway, the left side, you will have a blind second shot. So ideally, hit it down that right side of the fairway if you want to see the flag.
I want to see that flag, don't you worry. I don't mess about, son.
Frank couldn't ask for anything more.
Just the lie there, too. It is sitting up like it's teed up.
Frank, drive down the right side.
Yeah, and it certainly opens up. Now you've got a full view of the flag, and this is birdie time. Should be safely on deck.
Good chance. Beautiful. Now for a birdie. That was an outstanding play.
Well, it's almost a guarantee there after that shot.
This for another birdie on this hole on the week.
And he does it. That lead's growing now. Back nine. Probably
just
do better.
Amazing
front nine.
Display. The records continue to fall.
I reckon, is this the one that I keep over hitting? I keep
Frank,
getting
so
it
much
up,
focus on the back nine here at the stadium course at TPC Sawgrass on the 17th hole with the island green. I think 13 gets lost sometimes, but the pros know. This is a really good hole.
Oh, it can be disastrous, too. That's, I think, what you're referring to, Rich. There's a big ridge in the middle of the screen that bisects the top side with the bottom side on the left. So even when the flag's on the left, you don't have to go directly at it, because that normally causes the problem with the wooden bulkheads down the left side. And
obviously I just missed it.
So something on the ridge can often run down towards the left. But we have seen the odd hole-in-one here over the years.
That's it, though. Get in your home.
Good solid par right
just
there.
Go home.
Frank Tiger certainly had his adventures here at 14.
Well, we'll never forget that. Spun it left. In the end, was very, very lucky to get away with six. Had it been seven, Garcia might have just caught him at the post. But he will, and we will, never forget 14.
Crowd loving it.
Good tee shot, good lie, and now a good chance to take advantage here on this hole. Frank, this is a position where a player is absolutely licking his chops here. Good chance to make a birdie.
Yeah, this is when this game just looks like fun. Bunkers don't seem to be in play. The only thing you're really looking at right now is just the flag.
Headed for the bunker, I think. Just
sort of
a bit offline and into the bunker.
It jinxed me.
And an awkward little bunker shot. Just splash it out. Let the ball run towards the flag.
Ah.
I'll tell you what. Phil the thrill. Phil Mickelson could not have done it any better. What a bunker shot. Settles in over the putt.
Yes. Got a par.
Continuing to putt with confidence.
Some manliers.
Frank, the 15th hole certainly has the respect of the professionals.
But you're right. This is a positional hole where just keep the ball down the left center. You can't go too far, though, because you'll get blocked out or you'll run out of fairway. From there, it's really about knowing where the flag is, what position on the screen, because this is another green that's not flat. If the second shot lands on the wrong portion of the green, it'll finish well away from the hole.
Frank, what's the key on this approach here at the 15th?
Well, knowing exactly where that pin placement is, Rich, there's mounding, there's that little gut out of the right side of this green. If you miss your mark here, that ball can easily finish 30 or 40 feet away.
Oh, it looked like he caught a flyer right there, Frank.
Well, I don't know what he caught, but this is way too much.
It's not.
Just averted danger right there. So
what?
Close.
Why does he have all the luck?
Birdie here yesterday, trying to do it again today.
And he does it. Of course he does it.
And he has it.
A good putt redeems all.
All 16. This one's a tougher.
Now the start of the gauntlet. 16, 17, and 18. Par 5, 16. Frank, Tiger made birdie here all 4 days in winning in 2013.
Fred Couples made that fantastic eagle many years ago. Hole bends a little to the player's left. You don't have to hit driver here if you're a long hitter, but you really must move that ball right to left.
Ooh-ar.
Playing his second shot here at the par five. Frank, not easy to keep your eye on the target when you've just splashed down.
Yeah, but on the flip side, too, one bad shot doesn't have to lead to two.
After hitting it in the drink, this is the fourth shot.
Yeah, it's hard to imagine. The scorecard is quickly adding up.
Oof.
And he's made the green.
At least I've got a par shot.
That's in for a par.
I think you should have to take your previous shot. Then have to like get it like quite a bit.
Now to maybe the most famous hole in the whole sport. It's the 17th here at the stadium course, the TPC Sawgrass. Frank, if you look at it on the card, it seems so simple. It's just 137 yards for the best in the world. It's a pitching wedge, maybe a 9-iron. And yet every year, we see nightmares galore.
And that's where you have to remind yourself what can and what does happen here. I normally cut the green in half here. It's 26 yards deep. So if you just take 13 yards off the yardage, you have 124 yards to the middle of the green. Has to be your target. This is no time to be a hero. You can still have a putt for birdie.
Been pretty good all day from this distance, just trying to take care of business.
Sorted. Pass. Not losing anything. And they're not catching me up. Not at all.
Now to the 18th hole here at TPC Sawgrass. 462-yard par 4, Frank, and another example of visual intimidation from the designer, Pete Dye.
Those wooden bulkheads that go all the way down the left side of 18 give you like an optical illusion, Rich. And there's not a single fairway bunker on the right to give you something specifically to aim at. So you've got to fixate on one of those trees. This is not a hole where you want to be looking at anything other than a specific target.
Frank, really good chance from this position to make a birdie.
Yeah, really the only thing he's looking at right now is the flag. This is a green light special.
You can see a little bit off balance on the tee, and that one is going to be in the rough.
It's not.
You have to think he'll be happy with that, given that it looked like it was headed right for the rough.
Yeah, it looked like that was the only place it was going to finish, but, it's a little bit unexplainable. Let's see what he does from here now. Lucky
break. Yeah!
Good putt.
I want to make a cup of coffee for the last one.
There you have it. Round three is finished, and it was a good one, Frank.
Yeah, after three rounds in, you really could start to see who could take home the trophy when it's all said and done. Great play, though, up until this point. Round four should be an absolute thriller.
Well, yeah, unlocking stuff. Unlocking lots of stuff. Half a mug. What for? I don't know what. Right, I'm gonna have a quick toilet break, but I won't be long. Be right back. Hey up peeps, sorry if I took a while, I was talking to our lass. Let's do this, the final day. Ooh, chocolate biscuits.
EA Sports and the Web.com Tour proudly present final round coverage of the Web.com Tour Championship. This is one of the most exciting days of the year in golf. It's the final round of the Web.com Tour Championship, the fourth and final stop of the Web.com Tour Finals. And Frank, this is the day that dreams are realized. And I'm talking about lifelong dreams.
You're exactly right, Rich. They say pressure is relevant, perhaps a putt to win a major championship or win a PGA Tour event. What about the thought of actually having another career? That's right, 18 holes. That's what it's going to take today. And maybe you have a career that's going to last for many a year going forward. But it all has to happen today.
That's clear. That's for me. In my best clothes because it's the final day. Not in my shorts anyway. Bang that over there. Nice shot. Oh well. Greens are going to be alright.
Frank, you want to get out of the gates quickly, hit the proper approach shot here at the first. What does the player need to look out for?
Well, there's two distinct levels to this green. There's that left side and then that collection area to the right side. Flag on the top, it's a very, very difficult shot because that bunker plum comes into play.
Well, this one should be safely on deck here.
Nice.
He's making the game look very simple right now.
Golf games just so relaxing.
And he's got it right on track.
Golf's pretty cool. I don't watch a lot of it. I watch it now
back,
and then.
The back birdies are trying to jumpstart this round.
It probably about 2 years
ago. Momentum moving in the right direction.
Last time I watched it, McIlroy won the Masters. I think 2014, maybe. Between 2013 and 15. Oof. You can just chill. Relax.
Great start.
It's hard to get angry at this game. I'm very emotional. If anyone's seen my other videos,
Frank,
I can get very emotional
at
some games.
Dog legs to the left, so there's a decision to be made here all the time, but a good hooking tee shot.
My FIFA World Cup qualifier. It really hit me in the fields. We should have won beat Brazil and Chile. I just got robbed. Now we're not getting to World Cup. It really hit me. I was proper broken. Heartbroken.
Like the looks of this one. Oh yeah.
Ooh, on the fairway. Did you have any doubts? I didn't have any doubts.
That's a good shot, right where you want to be, in the fairway here at number two. Okay, the second shot now at this par five.
If you are new to my channel or my Twitch, if you don't like golf, don't worry, I play plenty of games. I stream everything I play because it's fun. People come and observe, spectate what you're doing. Don't even have to say anything. I'll talk to myself, as always.
Player elected to lay back here, Frank, but still a chance. Green light special.
It is. A good layup here in the middle of
it's
fairway.
It's entertainment for people.
Any flag position
people are enjoying it. I'll keep playing it. It's because a few select few people that like the game I'm playing at the minute. I just want to start playing.
Oh no, look out, Frank. Oof. I think he flushed that one.
Oh, this is going gone.
Wow, lucky break right there, Frank.
Wow. That's what everyone else is going to say, except him.
Made a par in his previous round. This time, it's for birdie.
No birdie. Par, though.
Well, that would have been a bonus had it gone in, but still, reasonable chance for par here.
Yeah, there's no damage. You're not going to birdie every hole.
Clean this up with a tap.
Clean this up with a tap.
Did the job right there. So we started with a par 4, then a par 5, and now the 177-yard par 3 third hole. Plenty of hazards here, Frank.
You really break this green up into three portions. Front left, front right, and that back, just on top of the ridge.
Seems to like it. Headed for the fat part of the green.
Yeah.
Yesterday, in their close, great opportunity for another one. Really not much to this. The only issue would be a lack of concentration or focus.
Yeah. Well done, life.
And he has it for birdie. Hole number 4 here at TPC Sawgrass, 384-yard, par 4, deep fairway bunker to the right of the landing zone. You want to avoid that. What else is there to look out for, Frank?
Those huge mounds on the left, they're just as penal, really, as the bunker on the right. So this is one where you have to pick an object in the distance. Really focus on that.
Good drive.
That one is in the fairway, down there about 290 yards. Second shot. Good look at the green.
Bad experience with water earlier. Yards, so I don't need to hit it 109, 106. Oh dear.
Maybe wet. Good clean contact and a nice result. And a chance for birdie coming up. Trying to make yet another birdie.
Oh.
So close.
And yet it still counts for another shot.
Need to get better at my putting.
Not a problem from there. Right in the middle. Fifth hole. Good par 4, isn't it, Frank?
If ever a hole was built for Lee Trevino, who used to love to cut it, this would be the hole. It just looks and screams for a shot that's hit left to right. And that's the only way, really, to avoid bunkers left and long, and that one that's all the way down the right side.
Frank, this is a position where a player is absolutely licking his chops here. Good chance to make a birdie.
Yeah, this is when this game just looks like fun. Bunkers don't seem to be in play. The only thing you're really looking at right now is just the flag.
Swing.
Appears to be what they call a commercial play. Very solid.
Ooh.
You can't hide the flag stick from that man.
He is just unbelievable. That never deviated offline.
Go on.
Everybody loves him. Birdie on the car.
Thank you.
Frank, this isn't a hole that sort of jumps out at you the way, say, 17 does.
Yeah, a lot of times people will just sort of gloss over it, but anytime you get a par 4 into 400 yards, it's a great opportunity. But once again, a positional hole. Take advantage of it.
That's it. Get it out middle. It shouldn't go running into any bunkers.
A great way to start a hole nicely placed in the fairway. Right now, the second shot here at hole number 6.
Yeah, not overly long, but be very aware of these palm trees that are short. Many a shot caught those trees coming into this green.
Chance for birdie nice. After that beautiful shot. It's the beautiful part of golf. Brand new day, new hole. Remember, he made a bogey here yesterday. This time,
Oh man.
I just pushed it.
Man.
That hurts. Different day, different hole. Made bogey yesterday. We'll do better this time, it looks like. seventh hole here at TPC Sawgrass generally plays into the wind, one of the stadium course's most difficult greens to hit, Frank.
It's a really weird tee shot here. You have those three little pop bunkers down the right, and then that bunker that meanders once again all the way down the left side. A bunker that's just slightly right of the canal. Very awkward angle off the tee.
Good start to the hole,
Frank. Yeah, nice drive there. Swinging well, too. This will certainly set up this hole.
Chance to set himself up for a good scoring opportunity with his second shot here. This has been a great performance so far. But, Frank, a long ways to go. Do you ever worry about complacency?
Yeah, sometimes it just looks like it's too easy. At the moment, the putts are going in, the iron shots are going close enough. But some things, you know, they don't happen by accident. He's got to still keep concentrating right now.
Frank landed it on the green.
It was never going to stop.
No, no chance. Just trying to make clean contact from the rough.
Oh.
Pretty good shot right
there. Good for a bogey. Not happy about that.
That's a bogey, but shot still up in the lead.
We start to see shots in hand really valuable.
TPC Sawgrass, the fabled stadium course designed by the legendary Pete Dye. Rich Lerner alongside Frank Navolo. And here at the eighth, Frank, most players are happy walking out of here with a par three.
And the reason why, it's a very narrow entry to this green. It's just littered with bunkers around, left, behind, to the side, and even short. Once you get further up the green, though, even though this is an undulating green, it starts to widen up. So don't get trapped into just looking at the front of this hole. I thought that at least pick up a shot. Birdie looked like a sitter. Now par.
Standing over this putt, concentrating on the read.
What?
Oh my goodness, he missed it. He missed the bunny. That's like missing a layup in basketball.
How?
All in the medics, Frank. Can't stop the bleeding here.
Just racking the bogeys up.
Two bogeys now.
Frank, I think this is one of the most fascinating holes on the golf course. The 583-yard par 5 ninth hole.
With technology now, a lot more players can reach this par 5 and 2. Gone are the days where it was a true three-shotter, but I remember when Sergio Garcia hit that three-wood from, what was it, 270, 280 yards? Still one of the best shots I've ever seen.
Nice.
Good tee shot, right in the short grass. Right in the heart of the fairway, green light special. Frank, for players looking to improve their putting, what are some of the training methods they can use?
I think speed is always is a good one when you get on the putting green and you just practice trying to putt inside that three-foot circle. Because in the end, all sports are the same. You're trying to focus in on the destination where that ball has to be delivered, whether it's tennis inside the court or basketball inside the rim. Putting is no different. As you get further and further away from the hole, then you just make an acceptable size circle that you're trying to putt within. So pace, very important.
Well, this one should be safely on deck here.
Oh, I wonder what are happening there. Wow, Frank, what's this? The first time this has happened.
Easy birdie.
Little redemption chance here. Had bogey yesterday.
Birdie.
Oh yeah, he's made it for a birdie.
Did you doubt me? I mean, seriously, did anybody doubt me?
Just a performance on the front side. He's hoping to keep it going here on the back nine, Frank.
The game is so much easier when you're swinging well, putts are going in. Really, you've just got to keep out of your own way. Tom Weisskopf was one of my idols growing up. I loved the way he swung. That swing right there reminds me of my idol.
It looks like Rory McIlroy, Frank, sticking the follow-through. Frank, really good chance from this position to make a birdie.
Yeah, really the only thing he's looking at right now is the flag. This is a green light special.
Yeah.
Oh, can't hide the flag stick from that man. Birdie here yesterday. This putt again for birdie.
Yeah. Oh yes. Oh yes indeed.
Good putt.
Let's go to the 11th. Now it's a par 5 and a fun hole, Frank. You can make anything from 3 to 7 here.
And that's why as the start of the back nine, especially on a Sunday, this becomes such a pivotal hole to start a run. Big body of sand down the left side that sometimes the longer hitters can get close to with the tee shot, but really it's the second shot. If you can reach this par 5 and 2, it's a very narrow green. The layup, well, it's actually an awkward layup, Rich, because you've got to push that ball to the left side, almost like a zigzag approach.
Here we go. Going for it again, even though I ended up at bunker last
time.
Headed
for the bunker? Not missing by much today, but enough to again be in the bunker. All right, so greenside bunker. What's he looking to do with this shot, Frank?
Well, really, you have to look at the amount of green you got to play with. You don't have to try and fly the ball right by the flag. Allow it to run. Plus, if you can get it to run like a putt, you never know. It might just go in.
Bit surprising. Misses the green in regulation here at the par 5.
Yeah, you'd think this is one of the easier holes on the golf course. So now, just trying to avoid 6.
Yes!
Yeah. Hit the flag and bounced away instead. Straight in. Amazing shot. And really deserves it.
Proper
up
on
to the
this.
12th, Frank, and a good birdie chance here.
Yeah, good old links, short par 4. This green really divides itself into about 3 sections. There's a little piece to the right, piece short left, and the one at back left. So as long as you know where the flag is, just push that ball into the section where it is. You get up there and you get 15 feet left for birdie.
Nothing to argue about there, right in the fairway. Now the approach to the 12th, Frank. What's the player looking at?
Well, it's a fun shot here for the second shot, especially if you've driven it down the right side, because then you can see the flag no matter where it is on the green.
Beautiful.
And now that for an easy birdie.
Just needs to keep it steady here over the putt.
Easy birdie indeed.
Just an amazing display. The records continue to fall. Hole number 13 here at Sawgrass, tricky 181-yard par 3.
You don't have to hit directly at this flag. When that flag's at the back there, you can use the contour. When it's on the left, once again, you can use the ridge in the middle of the green. Matter of fact, one of the hardest hole locations is when it's in the front right, because that's when you have to be perfect.
Yeah.
Really in control of this hole. Birdie yesterday, and another opportunity on the way. He really likes this hole. Made birdie yesterday. Can he do it again today?
Yes, I can.
Continues to amaze, yet another birdie, and what a day it's been. Frank, historically in this great championship, 14 has proven to be a pivotal hole.
Everybody focuses on the finish here, but you're absolutely right, Rich. This can be an absolute scorecard record, because if you spin your drive left, the drop back, perhaps on the ladies' tees, you can make 6 in a heartbeat. You try an air to the right, you can make 6 from the mound. So good drive down 14. Gives you a chance for that fast finish.
That one is in the fairway, down there about 290 yards.
Frank, this is a position where a player is absolutely licking his chops. You're a good chance to make a birdie.
Yeah, this is when this game just looks like fun. Bunkers don't seem to be in play. The only thing you're really looking at right now is just the flag.
Yeah.
Just a pure strike. Perfect result. He'll have a good look at birdie now.
Out there. Got it further. Oh, he did it! So I can't use the putt.
Said it over and over. Another birdie.
Birdies all around.
Frank, the 15th hole certainly has the respect of the professionals.
But you're right. This is a positional hole where just keep the ball down the left center. You can't go too far, though, because you'll get blocked out or you'll run out of fairway. From there, it's really about knowing where the flag is, what position on the screen, because this is another green that's not flat. If the second shot lands on the wrong portion of the green, it will finish well away from the hole.
Nice. Nearly 300 yards. Look at that. He does.
Frank, once again, this position is so important as we look at the second shot to the 15th.
Yeah, you're looking at the flag here. You're looking at birdie. But if you miss, that big bunker on the left will swallow it up. And there's two little pop bunkers on the...
Oh!
Yes!
Oh.
He's holding. Unbelievable. From that distance...
Oh! What a shot! What a shot!
You licking your chops here, Frank, as a player, when you get to this tee box?
Well, it's an opportunity. A four here.
I can't believe
makes
it.
Makes better when you walk to 17 and then 18. So, a four here is more than just making a birdie on a par five.
Just that Watson.
That's a good start to the hole, right down the middle.
Second shot.
Not looking good, Frank.
No, I think it's wet.
Frank, we've all been there. You hit one in the water, you're
damn
down.
You, water.
How do you regroup?
You've got to start from scratch again. Everybody's going to hit bad shots. That's just the nature of the game. But compounding mistakes, that's the problem that you want to avoid.
This now the fourth shot after the last one was in the water.
Yeah, just somehow just get it on the green.
Full power swing.
Seems to like it. Looks like it's headed for the green. Frank, not close, but
he's getting
this
in for a par.
Not bad.
Oh, that's excellent. Seriously, given the conditions, Rich.
Been pretty good all day from this distance. Just trying to take care of business.
He told me to hit a straight shot.
Robbed, Frank.
No, it's like kissing your mother-in-law.
It's like kissing your mother-in-law. Oh, commentators online, I have missed you.
This situation, Richard, bogey's not all that bad. Still has.
There should be an online. Everyone should be able to hear the commentators if you're doing it turn-based.
Frank, you think about
like,
heartache here at 17.
Should have the option to have one or not.
What comes to mind?
Well, obviously, Sean O'Hare is the first memory. I remember Len Matisse messing the hole up. Sergio Garcia just a couple of years ago when he was trying to make two. And you're punished so severely at 17 for a miss, but you're rewarded too for bravery. And it's that fine line between being a hero and a fool. And it comes down to 137 yards.
See if he can go one better than yesterday when he made par.
Nope.
Putt for birdie.
Oh, yes. Oh, I didn't think I did it, but I did.
Great.
And I've won it.
Beautiful.
But anyway, put it on last hole. I was probably celebrating.
People always talk about 17 being visually intimidating. Frank, what about 18?
If there's a little bit of wind off the right, the tee shot is so much easier. But if that wind is coming off the water, not only do you see the water and the wooden bulkheads, you see all the rough and the trees on the right. And of course, then you start bringing five,
oof,
six, seven, even eight into play.
Whoa.
That's what makes this tee shot so hard.
Frank, really challenging second shot here at the home hole, the 18th.
You have to be decisive going in here. You can see all the trouble in front of you. Water left, that mounding on the right. Neither place really is good to go. So somehow you've got to muster up your best shot.
That's good stuff right there. Wonderful approach. And now a really good look at to win the Web.com Tour Championship.
Oh.
That hurts. Oh, man.
I just pushed it.
Boy, that hurts. So a tester from 4 feet.
What?
Frank, amazing how this hole has gotten away.
Yeah, he's not Robinson Crusoe. Happened to everybody that's played this game.
No, he's not happy.
No problem with that one.
Not happy at all. Could have finished stronger, but we've finished.
Now
we
to the final hole here at TPC Sawgrass, 462-yard par 4. Frank, is this one of the toughest finishing holes in the sport?
It is, because the simple reason you've played 17 holes. And the job isn't done yet.
L 14. Stats are going up slowly but surely. Oh yeah, I know. I won it. I won it. Oh yeah, I won it. Oh yeah. Freezer McRoebuck. I got my PGA Tour card. EA Sports announced today that Freezer McRoebuck will be joining their roster of athletes. Freezer is a talented athlete with a ton of upside. A brand new representative for EA Sports said, "We're proud to add Freezer to our team as we continue to grow our brand globally." So I will use their stuff. Damn you, EA. Power. I'm happy with my power. I'm not changing it for nothing. I'm already wearing their clobber. Upcoming event. Career Builder Challenge. Ah, so it's a tournament. Alright. That's cool. That's cool. Rory. What's my ranking? Number one, apparently. Sweet. Sweet. Hybrids. Place all. Ooh, let's change shaft on some of these. Driver will change the shaft. Or, I'll change on this one. Right then, guys, that is it from me. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know what you reckon. Do you want to see more of this? Because I'll happily play more of this. And just let me know what you say, think in the comments or on Twitter at Freezer_Roebuck. Thanks for watching, guys. It's been a pleasure. Ciao.